Hello everyone, I am Dr. Anil Mehta. I am Professor, School of Business and Commerce, Manipal University, Jaipur. Earlier, I was also former head and professor in the Department of Business Administration, University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. Today, we'll be talking about emerging trends in HR. Friends, as you know that around three decades ago, most of the organizations throughout the globe enjoyed a strong competitive edge on account of having their large capital base, vast market, or the technology. But today, the scenario has completely changed. In fact, today, every organization is having equal opportunity to access technology, to access to any market, and of course, finances can be obtained from anywhere. So, the traditional competitive edges have now been neutralized. So, the question arises, what can be the strongest competitive edge in today's highly competitive environment? And the answer is, it is the quality of human resources in an organization. It is the effective human resource management that can provide a strong competitive edge to the organization. In fact, human resource management is not only essential at the lower level or middle level in the organization, it is equally important at top level. And it is said that today human resource management is not an allied area, but it is extremely important to manage human resources at different level, and it has become strategic HR. Earlier, we were talking about more and more about the individual performance, which has been now replaced by the teamwork. Earlier, we were talking about the specialization and super specialization, but now the time has come for multi-skilling. Today, what we are observing is that people have become business partners. They are not merely employees, but they have become the business partners. Earlier, there was a greater focus and importance of finance and financial capital. But today, what has become more important is intellectual capital in the organization. Earlier, there was not much emphasis on human resources and it was not considered a vital. But today, what has happened is that what is the level of performance, what is the level of commitment of people, that has become earlier important. So, what we find? A paradigm shifts. And in fact, earlier we were talking in terms of organization of business, but now today HR has become a subject where business of the organization has become extremely important. And the intent of new HR paradigm shifts is upon strategy, structure, and culture of the organization. Today, HR has become quite challenging due to wide variety of reasons. There is a cutthroat competition almost in all the sectors. We all know today is the time of IT, and HR is no exception to it, and more application of HR in IT in the field of HR we are finding. Similarly, the pace of acquisition, merger, diversification has increased day by day. Now, similarly, what we are finding is that today, even at the grassroots level, young and bright people are coming. They are quite educated also. They are not semi-literate or illiterate, but there is a common thing that now, even at the grassroots level, people are graduate or gross graduate level. Similarly, what we find is that there is an increased trend in stress and frustration in the organization. There is an increase in the number of female employees in the organization, and the role of trade unions are also changing. In fact, the role of trade union earlier was not so constructive as it has become today. Now, the office bearers of trade union are more mature, educated, and they put their demand before management on some solid information and base. Similarly, now organizations are trying their best to redesign the jobs so that they may become more interesting and challenging. Now, it is focused that employees should be involved at every level in the organization, and employee engagement has become a very, very important subject nowadays. Similarly, outsourcing, downsizing, re-engineering, all these things are emerging very fast. Similarly, HR cost has also increased. On one hand, we are talking about the cost control, but if you apply HR interventions, then there may be escalation of cost. How to make a balance between rising HR cost and simultaneously maintaining the motivation level of the employees, that is also quite important. Workforce diversity has become another important subject which is being dealt by the HR professionals. Similarly, in the field of HR nowadays, the challenge is how to manage changes in the organization. And nowadays, CSR has become a buzzword, and in most of the cases, responsibility of CSR activities in the organization has been entrusted to HR department. So we can say that there is a complete paradigm shift in the field of HR. Earlier, the traditional functions of HR were procurement, development, maintenance, integration, compensation, and separation of people from the organization. Now, all these activities have now been redefined. Now, the task of HR is to enhance the enabling capability of the people in the organization. We can say that now HR has become more strategic. HR professionals, HR department has become just like a business partner. HR department is an important instrument for changes in the organization, and HR is considered as a prime source for the organizational success. Now, looking to all these changing scenario, the question arises that what are the new trends, now new things that is coming in the field of HR, and what would be the HR scenario in the years to come? Now, earlier, there was greater focus on employees' competence, qualifications, commitment, etc. Now, it is being emphasized that, of course, all these things are important. Employee must be highly qualified, quite competent person. He should be committed towards the organization. But the most important thing is that is value creation and meaning. What value an employee can create and how he or she can become meaningful for the organization. And similarly, employees are looking for the organization which are not merely profit driven, but they are basically purpose driven. In fact, globalization has influenced not just one area, but almost all the important segments of economy are being affected by the globalization, and HR is no exception to it. Global sourcing, global development assignment, and reward equity, they are all affecting because of the globalization, which HR manager has to deal. Nowadays, what is more emphasized is that is teamwork in the organization. Of course, individual capability and individual performance is very important, but merely individual competence and performance is not enough because people have to work in group. So, organizational capability and teamwork is being emphasized at various forums by the HR professionals, and organizations are taking more and more steps to ensure that employees should work as a team. Similarly, what is very important today is, and it's the biggest challenge today is, that is skill crunch or skill gap. It is really paradox that on one hand, organizations are facing sometimes the surplus manpower in various departments. Similarly, at the recruitment level also, we get large number of applications, but simultaneously there are many areas where there is a skill shortage or skill gap, and organizations are finding it real challenge that how to bridge that talent or skill gap. Now, organizations are realizing that unless they join hand in a formal way, unless they work in a structured way to bridge that gap, perhaps it would be very difficult to meet that gap. And that's why now sector skill councils are being emphasized and organizations have joined their hand to bridge that gap also. Similarly, technology has affected HR very significantly. Some of the important trends in the field of technology are particularly affecting HR, that is cloud computing, which is extremely helpful in HR field also for taking variety of decisions regarding manpower. Use of analytics is increasing in the field of HR for various decisions, and mobile phones are affecting our social life, and organization life is also influenced by mobiles. Now, with the use of mobile, organization can access any employee 24/7. Whether it is employees survey regarding introducing any policy, giving any management tip to the managers, or to get the quick feedback and communication, mobiles are playing a very positive and constructive role in the organization through which the employees get connected to each other. And these social medias and blogs are also important through which the management can get feedback from the employees and their reactions. Similarly, this millennial workforce has posed lot of challenges in the field of HR. Nowadays, employees want more autonomy. They want that their bosses should not merely act like a boss, but they should act like a friend, philosopher, and guide. Our young employees today want to experiment. They want more and more empowerment. They are having a good number of expectations from HR. And nowadays, HR professionals, HR departments are focusing that how these increasing aspirations of the employees can be met. Similarly, one important trend that we are finding today is that with the increasing number of working couple and this nuclear family, now it is not merely the husband or wife that is the stakeholder in the organization, but even the spouse is also considered as a stakeholder. And when both are working in the organization, then again HR professionals have to meet their requirements and expectations simultaneously. Now, another important thing is that since there is a dearth of talents at various level, so organizations and HR department are trying their best to recruit best and the brightest people in the organization. Similarly, what is most important is that trying the new sources of recruitment in the organization so that out of the shortage of the people, organization may get the best people in the organization. Similarly, retention management has become extremely important, and organizations are trying their best to get the best and the brightest people through various sources and then retaining them. There are three important C's to retain the people, and these three C's are number one, compensation, number two, career, and number three, comfort. If HR department can provide attractive compensation, if there is a growth prospect in the organization, if the working conditions are good, then of course we cannot minimize the retention, the attrition rate to zero, but we can retain people substantially. Then today there is a greater focus nowadays on performance management. Organizations are becoming performance driven, and for that purpose, those who are high performers, they are handsomely rewarded, but greater focus and attention is being given to those who are not so good in their functioning. And nowadays, line managers are supposed to own the responsibility of good performance in the organization. Similarly, because of the tough competition and cost control, now whenever new HR interventions are introduced, they are always questioned in terms of their outcome. Whether employees are to be sent for conference seminar or training program or any HR intervention is introduced, then management is always asking the outcome, how it is going to enhance the business or how it is going to beneficial for the organization. And I would say that it is not the organization who is looking for the employees, good employees, but it is vice versa also, that is now employees are also looking for the organizations which are really good. So now the concept is fast changing, and now the new emerging concept is employer of choice. It is not the big organization or it is not merely the handsome package that really attracts the employees today. What is most important for many organizations today in the context of employees' preference, that is reputation, credibility of the organization. Because the reputation of the organization is one that also affects the individual prestige and credibility of the employees also. Those organizations who are ethical in their practice, who believe in high moral values, those who really provide a good learning environment, where the top management leadership is really quite credible, and those who are focusing on employees' personal problems, they are really preferred. So the new concept which is fast emerging is employer of choice, and HR department has been given this task, that is the employee should get all these expectations and aspirations fulfilled. Similarly, innovations have been done in the field of reward and recognition. Most of the organization, because their resource constraints, are nowadays focusing upon variable rewards, that is reward linked performance. And organizations are doing benchmarking. They always compare that what the industry trend is and which is the best organization as far as the compensation packages are concerned. But here the point is that unless the employees consider that reward really attractive, perhaps it will not give him or her real motivation. So communication of compensation package in a positive way is another important trend, and for which the HR department is primarily responsible. HR department is also looking for the leadership at various level, those who are having innovative thinking, those who are focusing on results, those who are quite empathetic and sensitive towards employees' problem, those who can deliver good results, they will always be preferred. And for that purpose, HR department is developing the potential leaders in the organization. And finally, I would say that there is a greater focus nowadays on industry-academia interaction. As already mentioned, that there is a talent crunch, and now the challenge before the HR manager and the department is to establish continuous linkage and liaisoning with the education institution. So, to conclude, I would say that HR is not a supporting activity today. HR is not an allied activity, but in future, the role of HR will increase, and those who are opting for HR as their major, particularly the students, they have a very, very attractive career. Thank you very much.